Good morning. So I'm going to talk something about lakes. Before talking further, let us have a status check. How was Bangalore? Bangalore was like this. Way back in 1911, this college was the boundary of Bangalore city. Many people may get surprised, but that is a fact. How it changed in 1984, all this yellow thing, it's all lakes. It's once upon a time, it's all full of lakes. And how is now, 2016, most of these lakes disappear. The statistics wise, we had 262 lakes in 1960. Currently, we have what? 62 lakes. What happened to those 200 missing lakes? The big question, yes, that is what it is. That is the question. What happened? How many of you agree that like our lakes still are there? Any? No? Okay. So, interesting fact is, we have lost or encroached most of the lakes. The reason is, we started depending on Kaveri water, which comes from almost about 100 kilometers away from Bangalore city. We started neglecting the maintenance of lakes, either by the government or by the public. There's hardly any participation from people's side. How many of us we go visit lake? Hardly, because lakes are not trustworthy to, like, you know, lakes are not worthy to visit these days. Why? It's either polluted or encroached, etc. There is hardly any budget provisions over the years by the state. And absolutely there is lack of coordination among different agencies. The agencies who are supposed to clean up our sewage system, or the agencies who are supposed to maintain our lakes. So what we gained over the last 100 years? We lost our water bodies. The water bodies in Bangalore has reduced from 3.4%, roughly about 5,700 acres in 1973. Currently, it is less than 1%. So welcome to the city of lakes, what the news media calls as city of burning lakes. City of burning, because lakes in Bangalore are burning. Let us have a status check. Citizens witness this and wonder, is it a volcano or a lake? The lake was burning near Bellandur. One morning, people were surprised, oh, lake is burning. People were panicked. They started calling fire brigade. The fun fact is that fire brigade also came to, you know, extinguish lakes, you know, fire in the lake. Very interesting, no? But that is a fact. Citizens also experienced like snowfall. Very interestingly, people around Bellandur Lake experienced this, but that is not the snowfall. It was a toxic fume which was coming out of Bellandur Lake. People also thought, oh, it's like Bombay Mithai is coming freely. Bombay Mithai, everywhere Bombay Mithai. So nice. But it's not Bombay Mithai. Later they realized it was a toxic fumes. The reason for all these things is there are robbers of lakes. In Bangalore, people also started robbing the lakes. The first thing what they did is they take away all the good soil, red soil, maroon soil, everything they took it from the lake bed. So the first thing was to destroy the lake characteristics, and they created a beautiful death trap. So beautiful. Wherever you go, outside Bangalore, or maybe in the peri-urban, of the Bangalore city, you see these scenarios. And citizens also feel these days, let my household garbage, let it go out from the house immediately. Without segregation, They just dump it wherever it is. So, but ultimately we know all these waste goes to the lake. One or the other way, it goes to the lake. Sewage water joining the lake. This is an important because throughout the city, we have hardly about like less than 60, 62 lakes now. But most of the lakes are polluted. What I feel, what do you feel? Yes, 90% of the people in the audience, you say the lake is polluted. So recently in 2017, so Karnataka government brought in some kind of notice, they were trying to bring some kind of notification. What is that notification? Denotification of lakes. It means the lakes which are not filling the water, getting filled with water, or the canals which are not bringing the water to the lakes, let us denotify it. For what reason? 1,500 lakes were under the list. If that was the case, for the last 1 week, Bangalore is receiving so high rainfall. Electronic City is getting flooded. Mysore Road is getting flooded. People are getting washed away in the floods. If these lakes were not there due to some denotification plan, what would have happened? Some more lives would have gone lost. I think nothing, in spite of all this, let us be positive. That's what is my inspiration to improve our immediate environment. My story, as a young researcher in 1988, this is how I was looking. So this is a research basin, river basin, where I was cycling almost about 60, 70 kilometers a day, running around every villages, almost 110 villages, about 1,120 square kilometers of area from Navalgund to Kittu to Dharwad, Dharwad to Saudati, Saudati to Navalgund. Even I was not finding drinking water to, you know, it was so difficult. Even I could see that like people were suffering to get even a bucket of water. I could see the several hands on single open well source because the groundwater was brackish zone. It's not necessarily groundwater, is always fresh water. Especially in North Karnataka, in many places, we do have a lot of brackish water. In that case, only the lake will have fresh water. So we need to protect the lake. Beginning of my interest about the protecting lake, this is how it started. Let us understand what is lake. It's an area filled with water. It supports our livelihood. And it's a common property resource. I think many of you may not understand what is common property resource. In our society, we had this kind of a land category called common property resources. Lake is one of that. Lakes, grazing lands, or maybe like, you know, community woodlots. So many things. But we have lost community woodlots, we have lost. We have lost, but only thing what is remaining is now the lakes. 99% of these lakes are on a non-perennial streams or perennial streams of a first order in a watershed catchment. Let us understand what is first order, what is second order. The first order is from the top of the watershed. The small canal brings in water, and that's where a lake is constructed. That's the first lake on a first-order stream. If two first-order streams are joining, then it becomes a second order. That becomes a slightly bigger lake. Now, my humble request to government is, we can easily protect all these first-order lakes in Bangalore. It is possible. If we don't do it, this is what we are going to suffer. Either extreme floods or we are going to suffer from acute drinking water shortage due to drought. We all have witnessed, for the last year, Bangalore did not receive much rains. Most of the lakes were dried up. Suddenly this year, with the grace of rain god, we received good rains. big challenges of lake restoration. The curbing the encroachment of lakes and also the feeder canals is a big challenge. The Karnataka government itself admits that almost like 250 kilometers of feeder canals which bring fresh water to the lakes are encroached upon or disappeared. So strange. Then second important thing is controlling the pollution. Various forms of pollution, whether it's a solid waste pollution or if it's liquid waste pollution, or whether it is like industrial effluents, getting released to the lakes is a big challenge. Now, if anybody would like to start lake restoration project, this is what the prerequisite. You need to prepare a DPR, you need to get the approvals, you need to get the fundraising done, and you have to coordinate with all sorts of departments, including the police. That is a big challenge. So my experience was that, like, in spite of doing all these things technically, then financially, getting, you know, finances on in my organization, I was forced to go to the court to get the approvals. That is, but still I did not, you know, get scared of it. Somehow I got the approvals with the court's permission and started doing the work at near Whitefield, just behind SAP Laboratories. The first thing was, I had to clean up almost 200 truckloads of solid waste. Then I had to desilt. Then I had to completely clean up this, weeds which are coming. Then I had to create new landforms. Now, how did I do it? And basic characteristics of the lakes also has to be rectified. Because lake has unique characteristics which unifies the surface water as well as groundwater, or it's a bridge. So we need to keep the water at the surface level. How do we do it? The basic characteristics of a lake is completely gone, where the clay, creamy layer of clay is gone, which is the retention layer. In most of the lakes, we don't have it. So then second thing is, okay, we have done everything, but how do I bring the water to the lake? Because the feeder canals are completely encroached upon. These feeder canals are within the habitats, in the villages, or maybe just adjacent to our houses. We don't know. The real estate mafia would have completely encroached our feeder canals and sold it as a site, apartment, etc., etc. But how do I know that there is a feeder canal just adjacent to my house or just below my house? After doing all this thing, I did not lose the hope. I started planting the trees, basically to enhance the biodiversity of lake, which has created healthy wetlands, which also created, I felt it was sort of a ripple effect in terms of groundwater recharge, in terms of healthy wetlands, and in terms of urban harmony with the nature, then reduced water conflicts, then improved health index. So we also created sort of a recreation places for all. So whether it's walking track, whether it's children play areas, whether it's providing benches for senior citizens, it's all part of this lake restoration. Then we also restored, promoted recreation space for young people. I just saw this young girl. It was not even completed. The restoration activity was not complete. She started cycling on this walking, track. I felt so happy that we need to provide so much of, outside spaces for young people so that they can spend at least about 15 to 16 hours outside their home, improve their health, and also contribute to our society. So reclaiming your immediate natural surroundings should be one of the important criteria. This is how the lake was earlier. It is just in front of the total environment building in Whitefield. This is a lake. You all agree this is a lake? No? Okay. Do you all agree that this is a lake? Okay. So that's how I think our challenge is to create healthy wetlands where all forms of life support, life, life, living things can survive on this planet. Creating a positive impact through wildlife photography competitions and also lake festival. This is one of the important idea so that like people can get attracted to visit the lake, take bird pictures or doing bird photography, whatever it is, or and improving their status of health in terms of physically or mentally or spiritually, whatnot. Ultimately, this season in 2017, this restored drake in a concrete jungle. I felt so happy, at least there is some green space or breathing space or lung space, what I call. Ultimately, in order to do all these things, water is must. So water is a mystery. No one knows. No one knows till today that how the water came to Earth 4.5 billion years ago. No one knows. But we all know that H2O is the water formula. But we are not able to produce this water in abundance. So it's the nature's gift. Let us protect it. Apart from here, water is important for our life. Our body is made up of almost 70%. Earth also has got 70%, but fresh water is only 2.5%. And out of 2.5%, lake has got 20%. Rest of it is all groundwater and seawater. There's only one planet. There are 7 billion people, 7 billion dreams. We need to consume with care. This is a message from UN Secretary General in 2015 during World Environmental Day. Remember, we must remember, even a small beaver animal builds dam for its survival. It conserves water. It protects Earth. I think we must remember that we contribute its effort. Thank you.